Hello all, in this video we will prove that tree colorability is NP complete. See, tree colorability basically means that a graph can be colored with three colors, that is maximum of three colors. So that is what exactly tree colorability is. For example, in general we will say K colorability, that is the graph can be colored with K colors, that is K colorability. So here tree colorability means a graph can be colored with three different colors so that adjacent vertices do not have same color. That is the concept of graph coloring. It is used for register allocation and all. So that is tree colorability. We will be given exactly three colors and we have to color a graph accordingly so that adjacent vertices do not have the same color. So we now have to prove that it is NP complete. So what we will do is we will take an algorithm that has already been proved to be NP complete and will reduce that algorithm to tree colorability. For example, we may take the SAT problem which has already been proved to be NP complete by Cook and Levin, and we will reduce that into tree colorability in polynomial type. Then we can prove that, then that will prove that tree colorability is NP complete also. Okay, usually tree colorability is actually an NP problem because to assign colors to a graph, I mean tree colors, okay, colors to a graph such that adjacent vertices do not have same color takes exponential amount of time. So and again, once a coloring scheme, that is this coloring color mapping to vertices is given, we can easily verify that. For example, if a given a graph is given and the color assignment to different vertices are given, we can easily verify that. We just have to check whether the vertices on the end of an edge is having same color or not. So verification is very easy, it can be done in polynomial time, but solving take exponential amount of time. So definitely tree colorability is actually an NP problem. Now what we need to do is we need to reduce SAT to tree colorability in polynomial time. Then that is sufficient to prove that, for the proof of tree colorability being an NP complete problem. So we will, SAT deals with formula, so we will take a formula phi of certain clauses, some C1 and C2 and etc. up to some K clauses, CK clauses, where each clause is having equations. Okay, so each clause is actually a disjunction of literals. Okay, and for example, we will assume that we are taking three Ciana formulas, so we will be having three literals in every clause. Okay, so that is each ci will be made up of some xi, x1 raised to I, or x2 raised to I, or some x3 raised to I. So each clause is consisting of exactly three literals, that is we are considering three Ciana formulas, so three SAT. Yeah, Cook and Levin has already proved that three SAT is also NP complete, so we can take that definitely. So so we are taking formulas because SAT deals with formulas. So this is a formula where C1, C2 are different clauses. Each clause contain exactly three variables, which are distinction of three variables. So that is the format of three Ciana formulas. We have discussed this in many of our previous videos, so I am not repeating. Now what we need is, we need to convert this formula into a graph, because SAT deals with formulas whereas colorability deals with graphs. So we have to construct a graph out of these formulas. So what we will do is, for every variable xi in the formula, we will create nodes for xi and also for xi complement. Then what we will do is, we will connect xi and xi complement to a graph with a common base node. So actually we are devising a graph with three colors. First color is the truth, T color, T truth. Second color is color false, and third color is a base color B. Okay, that is we are constructing a graph with these three colors. So this is how the construction is done. For every variable xi, we are connecting xi to xi and xi complement to each other and also to a common base. This is how we do the connections. Okay, For example, if the formula is like, if a clause is CI is equal to A over B over C, if the clause is like this, what we will do is we will create node for A, we will create node for A complement. Then we will connect these two nodes together and to a common base color B. Now if we have another variable B, so we will create node for B and also for B complement, and we will connect these two nodes to the common base. And again for C, we will create node for C and node for C complement, and we will connect these two nodes to the common base. So this is one thing that we need do, what we do. And again the next thing that we do is we will create a BTF triangle. So we will be having a node for T and we will be having a node for false, and will be connected to this. So this is the basic architecture of converting the formula into colors. We have more that we call as an OR gadget. I'll explain how it is created. For example, if the clause is C1 is equal to A O B O C, the OR gadget is created like this. OR gadget is created by, for A we will have this A, for B another variable we will be having B, then we will be connecting these two together using an OR, and now we will be having C, then C also will be connected to the result, and this will give you the result for A or B or C, such that if at least one of A or B or C, the result will be true, otherwise it will be false. Now this is the resultant value. Now we will be connecting this value to the BTF triangle. So this is the basic design of an OR gadget, where A, B, C are the different variables, and first we can we'll process two of them. Now to that we will add the third variable and we will get the result of A O B O C. Actually this is the result for A O B. Now that value will be connected to a base truth false triangle. This output will be connected to both base and false nodes. Okay, so this is the basic architecture of an OR gadget. Okay, so given an equation, we will see how we can establish those connections. So we will take a simple example. For example, let the formula be A over B over C now, and A over negation B over C. Okay, assume that this is the formula. Now we have to convert this into a graph following all these concepts, isn't it? So as I told, we have to create a node for A and also a node for A dash. Now you have to create, and these two should be interconnected and also should be connected to a base, common base. Now we have B, the variable B. So for B you have to create a node, for B complement you have to create a node. Both these nodes should be interconnected and should also be connected to the common base. Now for C and for C complement you have to construct nodes. They should be connected to each other and also should be connected to the common base. Now we have created the followed the first step, that is we have constructed nodes for every variable xi and its complement, and we have connected them to the common base. So we have done that particular step. Now the next thing that we need to do is we have to create the OR gadget for every clause. So the first clause is A or B or C. So I have to take A from this and B from this. So I can connect these two at a time and I'll get A O B in the output, isn't it? Now the third variable is C. So I can take C from this and have to establish the next OR gate. Now as I told, the result has to be connected to both true and sorry both base and false node of the BTF triangle. So I have to have a BTF triangle where B stands for base, F stands for false and T stands for true, and this output has to be connected to both base and false. Okay, now the next close A, I can take A from here. I am using another color. Yeah, I can take A from here for the second close A. Now negation B, I can take negation B from here. So I'm forming the first OR gate. Now C, so I'm taking this C and forming the next gate. Now as I told, one output should be connected to base and the next output should be connected to false. So this is close 2 and this is close 1. So close 1 has been marked in blue color and close 2 has been marked in red color. The basic outline is marked in color black. Yeah. So this is the graph that you are getting. Now let's so we have reduced SAR to a graph. Now we need to check whether this reduction is meaningful reduction. If it is meaningful reduction, whenever the formula is satisfiable, the graph should be three colorable. Okay, so whenever this formula is satisfiable, that means both the clause should be giving you output true, because this the clauses are connected by AND. So if and only if both the clauses are connected by an AND, you will get the formula to be satisfiable, isn't it? Formula is satisfiable. So there will be at least one variable from A or B or C that is giving you 1 in the output, isn't it? Then only this clause will be satisfied. See, when A or B or C, at least one of them is satisfiable in this clause, for this clause you will get this output as true, isn't it? So this true is connected to a base color and a false color. So the node true, that this the value is true here. True is color true. Color true is connected to color B and color F. It has never been connected with color true again. So that is the condition for graph coloring, isn't it? Two adjacent vertices should have different color. So this is the vertex true now. So this bears the value true. Or this node is having the value true. This is again a node. This node is having the value true, but that node is connected to the node B and the node F, containing colors, base color and false color respectively. So this is following all the conditions of coloring. Again, A and A dash. If A is true, A dash is definitely false. So if this is color true, this is color false for sure, and this is color B. So again we are following all the conditions regarding colors. So here also B and B dash, if B is true, B dash is false, they are color differently and they are connected to base, which is having another color, the third color. So this is true. Again, and the second clause also should be true. So A or negation B or C, one of them should be true. If one of them is true, the value that you are getting here is true. So again, true is connected to base and false. So now two adjacent colors are same. Again, B and F are connected to T. So now two colors are same. And now two adjacent colors are same. See, this is a node and this is another node. This is a node and this is another node. Okay, all of these nodes are having some true or false value. Because this is an OR, output of OR should be either true or false. So this is one color, can be true or false. This is another color, can be true or false. This is one color, true or false. This is another color, true or false. Okay. So, we proved that if the formula is satisfiable, the graph can be color true. Again, if we are thinking the opposite, if the graph can be three color, the formula will definitely be satisfiable. Because if the graph can be three color, that means this is false, this is base. So this node should definitely be true, because if this is false, you are connecting false to false. That cannot be the case. Again, you are connecting the node here also with base and false. So this color should definitely be true, because if this is false, you are connecting false to false, that false color to false color, that cannot be the case. So in whatever way you think, if the formula is satisfiable, the graph is tricolorable. The graph is tricolorable, the formula is satisfiable. That is, we can meaningfully reduce SAT to tricolorability. Hence, proving that tricolorability is NP complete. Hope you got it. Thank you.